In this video lecture, I am going to talk about the Pareto analysis, or you can say the Pareto chart. First of all, I will discuss briefly about how we can interpret the Pareto chart and what are the theoretical background of the Pareto chart. And then I will develop the Pareto chart using Excel, as well as there is an add-in available in Excel which is called as QI macros, which is quality improvement macros. So using that macro, we will try to develop the Pareto chart. So first of all, what is a Pareto analysis, or you can say Pareto chart? Basically, Pareto analysis and Pareto chart is a type of bar chart where on x-axis we have the type of issues, or you can say the type of problems we have, and whereas on the y-axis we have the frequency. Okay, mean how many times the particular type of problem or the type of issue has occurred. Right, whereas corresponding to the y-axis we have the percentages, right? And this line is represented the cumulative percentage line. Okay, so the idea behind the Pareto chart is to prioritize those issues which we should address in order to improve the process. So that means usually when we are saying the Pareto analysis, mean we are applying 80-20 rule. What does the 80-20 rule means? So on the percentage axis, here is the 80%. So if I drag this line, so that means if I drag down that one, so that means if I am, you know, focusing on missing screws and missing clips type of problems, okay, so if I solve these two types of problem, which are approximately 20% out of all, so I would be able to solve my 80% of the problem. Similarly, I have given the example that 80% of your phone calls goes to the 20% of the name of your phone list. Similarly, on a city, 20% of roads handle 80% of the traffic of the cities. Okay, and so on. So, but it is not compulsory that you always apply the 80-20 rule. You may apply 70-30, 75-25, or 90-10. So the main concern about the Pareto analysis is to separate the vital few from the tribal many, right? So therefore we should focus on the vital one, however we would be able to solve our main problems. Okay, so let me draw this Pareto analysis using Excel. So I have the data set, that is the complaint types I have, okay, and then number of complaints. So in order to draw the Pareto chart, what we need to do is, first of all, we need to sort the data descending order wise. So with respect to their frequency, so I sorted the data. So the first complaint type having the maximum number of complaints, and the second type having the second highest number of complaints, which is this one. Okay, and the third one is cleaning, and so on. Okay, the in order to draw the Pareto chart, first I need to sum this one. Okay, so this is sum of all the complaints, right? And then we need the percentage column. So how we can do that? So we will do equal. Okay, so then we have to select this particular cell, okay, divided by this cell, and then we should absolute this particular cell, okay, by freezing it, dollar sign and dollar sign, then multiply by 100 in order to compute out the percentage. Okay, then after that we can drag down this one. Okay, so I have already selected the number sign, however I would get the percentages up to two digits, right? So then the next thing we need to find out the cumulative percentage. Okay, so I should write down cumulative percentages. So how we can calculate that one? That would be the first percentage as it is. Okay, then equal this sum. Okay, the next percentage. Okay, after doing this one, we can drag down, so the formula will be automatically applied. That means this plus this would be equal to this, then this plus this would be equal to this, and the last cumulative percentage would be equal to 100. Now, in order to draw the cumulative Pareto chart, what we will do, we will select all the first two columns, that is the type of the complaint and the frequency, or you can say count, and then we will select the control key from your keypad, okay, and then select the cumulative percentage column. After that we will go to insert. Okay, then from the bar chart over here, we can select this one. Okay, this is basically the side-by-side bar chart. So after that, what we will do, we will click on the second type of the chart. And then after clicking on these bars, we will click right click and then change series chart type. Okay, once we click over here and then from the bottom, the cumulative percentage, the cluster column, instead of using cluster column, we should use the line with marks, or either you can use this simple lines. So I'm using line with marks and then click over here in order to make this secondary column, which is against the you can see the frequency line, which is a percentage line. So here we have, right? And then we can do that, press OK. So right now on x-axis we have the type of complaints, on y-axis we have the counts, whereas over here we have the percentages. But we want that the highest value must be 100. So in order to do that, what we will do, we will select this percentage side, right click and then format axis, and then we can write down format up to 100, right? So this is 100. So as you know that you cannot change the type of the chart using these different types of options. Okay, either you can select this one, whatever, or you can use the quick type of charts, right? Whatever the type you want to use it, you can do that, right? So this is just the formatting. So let me show you another way. There is another way from the Excel, that is if you go to insert and then if you select this one again, and in the recommended chart from the bottom, it is always showing us the Pareto chart. Okay, so as I have already selected this one, so this is available in 2019 version. I believe it is also available in 2016 version as well. So this is by default, you will get the Pareto chart. So there is no need to do the formatting which we did earlier. Okay, so there's a third way to draw the Pareto chart, that is using the QI macro, which is an add-in basically available in Excel. Okay, so I already installed it. After so in QI macro, there is no need to do to calculate the percentage, or even there is no need to do the sorting. So just you need to select this one, the by default, even we haven't sorted this data set. We can click on Pareto chart, and this is asking how many number of bars you want. So I am using by default. So that means it will show me maximum up to 9 bars. So after that, if there is any bar, it will show me the bar with the other's name. Okay. So right now I am saying press OK. So this is the Pareto chart with the QI macro. So as you can see that if we apply the 80-20 rule, so approximately right now it is showing us that if we would be able to solve our the first three type of complaints, we would be able to solve approximately 84% of the problem. Okay, so that means that as I told you earlier that we are trying to differentiate the vital few issues from the trivial many. Okay, so that's why we are saying that if we would be able to solve the room service complaint, reservations complaint and cleaning complaint, so that means we would be able to solve 84% of the problems. So thank you so much. See you in the next video.